What I'm going to talk about today is about the Tusky. Ever heard of Tusky?
No.
No, of course not. We discovered it recently, last couple of years, tested it, and we published it recently. And I'm going to talk about it today, explain it, what it means, so that afterwards you know what it means, what it entails, and it will change your life. At least it will change how you perceive your performance, how you evaluate your performance, and how you evaluate the performances of other people. But before I'm going to explain and discuss in more detail Tusky, I'm going to talk about another interesting topic, and that's the game of golf. Who's playing golf? Only one. Golf is fun to play. For several reasons. I'm not going to discuss all these reasons. What I'm going to discuss is what you can with golf, and that's you can improve yourself with golf. It's easy to monitor your progress in the game of golf. You play a round of 18 holes, and the goal is to complete that round of golf in as few shots as possible. An average professional player needs approximately 72 shots. A quite good amateur golfer needs, let's say, 90 shots to complete a round. So an amateur golfer, who never broke the 90s, his or her goal might be, for the next round, to break the 90s, to complete a round in 89, 88, 87 shots. Now, if you look at goal-setting literature, you are familiar with goal-setting literature, because goals are maybe the most frequently concept in psychology, in all kinds of psychologies. But a basic model in goal setting theory are cybernetic models of goal pursuit. That amateur golfer, for example, sets a goal of breaking the 90s, so complete a round in less than 90 shots. He starts the round, plays the game, and ends finally with a score of 86, which is great. Never broke the 90s, and now in this round broke the 90s and made the round in 86 shots. So he should be very happy with his real results. I think very positively about his outcome, etc. And the main question today I want to discuss with you, is that true? Does it work that way? People who set an improvement goal, they perform, they improve themselves, and they are happy. Is that true? They might be unhappy. Why? Because people don't get only the information that's aligned with their goal. They receive additional information. This particular player played golf in a tournament and learned afterwards that he ended at position 73 out of 100. That's not a spot in a ranking you're particularly proud of. So that person might, even when his goal was to improve, might be very unhappy with this result, because he learned and he got very clear, unambiguous information that he performed worse than other people, although he improved. Now, that's an idea we tested over and over again the last couple of years. And what we found, I can tell you already, what we found is that this particular golfer is not happy with his result. Social comparison information is overwhelming, is overpowering. It's the only information or the most important information people pay attention to when they self-evaluate their performances. Even if they pursue a self-improvement goal. I'm going to discuss it in more detail from the perspective of achievement goal theory. Achievement goal theory is about the question, when do I feel competent? Do I feel competent when I improve, or do I feel competent when I perform better than other people? And people who use the self as a comparison standard, they compare themselves how they did before, they are focused on temporal comparison information. And they set mastery goals for themselves, self-reference mastery goals. The self is the standard of comparison. People who feel competent when they outperform other people, they rely particularly on social comparison information. They set performance goals for themselves, other referenced performance goals. Now, that's the idea, and that's what we ask people before they complete a particular task. We ask people in lab situations, in field situations, what's your goal for this particular task, or more general, in your studies, in your work, etc. To illustrate, in a basic experiment, we ask people to complete one version of a particular task. They complete it, they know the task, and then we ask them, okay, in a minute you start version two, similar task, another version. What's your goal for that particular task? So sometimes people can freely choose a goal, set a goal for themselves. Sometimes we impose a goal on the individual. We said, for the next version, your most important goal is to improve yourself, to pursue a mastery-based goal. So we let people think about that goal, so that made them more vivid, etc. So they really that goal is really salient for them at that moment when they start working on the task. Then they complete version two, and then they receive feedback. They receive clear, unambiguous feedback if they improved and how other people did on the task. And then, after receiving feedback, we simply ask them, okay, how did you do on the task? What's your mark? What mark do we give on a 1 to 10 point scale? Now, what we find over and over again in the lab, when goals are imposed on individuals, when people freely choose a goal, in field settings where people pursue their freely adopted goals, over and over again, we found an overpowering effect of social comparison information. We found effect sizes high in 0.50, over and over again. So it's a huge, huge effect. People who are performing worse, they give them scores between 3 and 4. If they perform better than others, they give themselves scores between 7 and 8. 4 point difference. They receive the clear and unambiguous information based on temporal comparison information, based on their performance. That's balanced feedback. So they really made huge improvement or deterioration. But these type of comparison had some effect, but a very small effect, negligible relative to social comparison. So that's what we found across situations, context, achievement domains, etc. So what, you might say? Now, that's, of course, it's very important. It interferes very seriously with people's self-regulation, because when you pursue a self-reference goal and you only value the information based on social comparison, there's a misalignment between your goal and the information you find most important. So that's not very optimal for your self-regulation. Mastery goals, it's a highly prevalent problem, because mastery goals are by far most popular among people. If I ask you your most important goal in several areas, 60 to 70% of you indicate that mastery goals are most important to you. So that misalignment applies to many people. So therefore it's important. So it's a valid question, how to overcome Tusky. And that was, of course, in our program, a major question. Now, we did experiments. The same as I showed you before, version one, goal, version two, etc. And we finally asked them again, how did you do on the task? And if you ask simply that question, social comparison overpowers temporal comparison information. But when you add simply this sentence, how did you do on the task? Considering your goal you set before version two, considering your goal of improvement, to perform better than you did before. Simply as that, then we found very different results. We found a very strong main effect of temporal comparison. So people considered only the information that was aligned with their mastery-based goal. The overwhelming effect of social comparison information we observed before without that addition completely disappeared. No main effect, no interaction effect. So very strong. So what's going to change your life now, and what's the lesson of today. For supervisors, for coaches, for teachers, in sports, in work, in education, if your athletes, your workers, your students evaluate their own performance, don't ask them simply, okay, how's your performance, but refer to the goal that's most important to them. And for most people, that's a mastery-based goal. Make it explicit at the beginning and refer to that goal when they think about their own performance. And then they will consider particularly the temporal comparison information so that their evaluations are aligned with their initial goals, which is optimal for self-regulation. Thank you.